There is a famous Indian television program named CID in which all murderers are eventually caught after the investigating officer known as Daya breaks open the door. Now let us catch the murderer with the help of this sumo wrestler and Shaggy. Here, we need to break open this door in order to catch the murderer. So if you had to choose between the sumo wrestler and Shaggy, whom would you choose to break open the door and why? Let's see. So we saw that while Shaggy hurt himself in trying to open the door, the sumo wrestler was able to break the door with a single punch. So why was he able to do this? What physical differences do we see between Shaggy and the sumo wrestler? Well, the sumo wrestler has a bigger build and hence has more mass. So we can conclude that the extent of damage that an object can cause is more if the mass of the object that is causing the damage is more. So, extent of damage caused is more if the mass of the object causing the damage is more. Now, this was a difficult case. Even after breaking open the door, the murderer is nowhere to be found. To catch the murderer, we have to break open another door, which is much bigger than the earlier one. Now the sumo wrestler tries breaking the door but is unable to do so. Then he gets an idea. He comes running from a distance and hits the door with a bang. And guess what? The door is broken and we are finally able to catch our murderer. So here we saw that while the sumo wrestler was unable to break the door with a single punch, he was able to break the door when he came running into the door. So what was the difference here between these two cases? Well, in the second case, the sumo wrestler had a greater velocity. So again, we can conclude that the extent of damage caused is more if the velocity of the object causing the damage is more. Now, the impact or extent of damage which an object can cause is called the momentum of the object in physics. And we've just seen that the momentum of the object is dependent on mass and velocity. So, the momentum of an object is given as mass into velocity. So, momentum is the impact or the extent of damage which an object can cause. And the momentum is equal to mass into velocity. So now, what is the SI unit of momentum? Since momentum is equal to mass into velocity, and the SI unit of mass is kg, and the SI unit of velocity is meters per second, so the SI unit of momentum is equal to, instead of mass, let's write kg, into, instead of velocity, we write meters per second. So, the SI unit of momentum is kg meter per second.